CuriosityStream has thousands of documentary films and shows available on demand on any device. We're the Netflix for nerds, the Hulu for history buffs, the Disney Plus for the scientist in us. There sure are a lot of streaming services, aren't there? CuriosityStream is the one you definitely need if you're the type to nature doc and chill, if you're an armchair astronaut, if you prefer physics to psychics, or perhaps you know a precocious paleontologist. Go to CuriosityStream.com to learn more and sign up today.
Sports bettors, are you ready? Are you ready for a faster way to win? When you bet with PointsBet, you get faster bets, faster withdrawals, and faster rewards. Experience this premium sportsbook for yourself and sign up with code BETSWEATS, BETSWEATS, to get $100 in free bets when you deposit 20. Must be present in New Jersey, Indiana, Iowa, or Illinois. Must be 21 or older. Additional T's and C's apply. If you or somebody you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-GAMBLER if in New Jersey and Illinois, 1-800-9-WITH-IT if in Indiana, 1-800-BETS-OFF if in Iowa.
Overrated or not overrated? That is the question. The Zaslow Show answers.
All right, we'll get back to listeners' list in a minute here. We'll let a few others get on board. We're trying to fill out the bottom five now. We got the top five for listeners' list. Top 10 movies you're embarrassed you love. Who's going to be filling out numbers 6 through 10? That's up to you, listeners' list. You hop on board. We're taking your calls. It's 786-360-0790. We do have a few more spots open here. So if you got that movie, this is a safe space. You don't have to be embarrassed. You got that movie you're embarrassed you love. Now is the time to help us fill out the rest of this top 10 list. Real quick, overrated or not overrated, Dan Day, what do you got for us here?
Well, I've got a couple of more embarrassing movies that I'll share with everyone in just a minute, but I want to get to overrated, not overrated, the rom-com. We're keeping it on movies right now. Some people say, oh, no, that ain't my stuff. Other people say, hey, man, you get with your lady, you're watching some rom-com, things are going good. Then there's other guys like me that say, I just like watching rom-coms. So overall, rom-coms, overrated, not overrated?
Not overrated at all.
Yes.
Love rom-coms. Look, if you're in a relationship, if you're married, those are the best kind of movies, okay? Because those are movies that you're both able to enjoy together. That's not the movie that, you know, I take my wife to see and I'm praying to the gods. I'm all of them. Every single god. I'm praying to them that my wife is enjoying this movie. Because if I get any type of hint, any sense that she's not enjoying it, it ruins the rest of the movie to me. But a good rom-com, you're both enjoying together. Rom-coms are perfect for dates. They're great at home on a Saturday night, a Friday night. You watch together. Yeah, rom-coms are fantastic. Love a good rom-com, all right? So there you go. Underrated. Not overrated. Yeah, not overrated. Let's go with that. All right, we're trying to fill out the bottom five for listeners' list. Here's what we got. You want to get on board here? You got that movie? Top 10 movies you're embarrassed you love. That's this week's listeners list. It's up to you. Here's the top five. The number one movie you're embarrassed you love is Pitch Perfect. Number two is Bridesmaids. Number three, Peggy Sue Got Married. We're kicking it old school there. Anthony helping us out. Number four, Clueless. Number five, Saturday Night Fever. Because Travolta's kind of a little bit weird in the music, and there you go. So that's the top five listeners list movies you're embarrassed to admit that you love. Number six, it belongs to Craig. He is in Fort Lauderdale. Craig, you get to fill out the number six spot. What's that movie you're embarrassed? Go ahead.
Oh, my God. I wasn't even scared to even call in. But that one, it would be Little Shop of Horrors.
Really? So you're embarrassed to admit you love Little Shop of Horrors? I mean, it's a musical, so
I'm gonna let you know.
It's a musical, so I guess like maybe you're embarrassed that you love a musical, but Little Shop of Horrors on the TV. Look, I can't tell you the last time Little Shop of Horrors was on TV, but if it were on TV, you're stopping, you're watching it.
I'll probably go home and watch it tonight just because I just said it out loud. But yes,
I gotta tell you, that's a good job out of you, Craig. I can't, Dan Day, you've seen Little Shop of Horrors, right?
Naturally,
I can't tell you the last time I saw Little Shop of Horrors. You know, Steve Martin, Rick Moranis, I forget her name, but, and, Feed Me, Seymour. What? That's a weird movie, man. And it's a musical. Little Shop of Horrors. I bet there's a lot of people, because, you know, my audience skews a little bit younger. I love you long time. There's a lot of people who have never seen Little Shop of Horrors. I haven't thought of that movie in forever.
It used to come on TV at night. I think they used to have like Disney specials on Sunday night. It used to be featured in the rotation. Right. I used to watch it. But maybe he's a little embarrassed because it seemed more as a kid's movie, although it kind of doesn't.
It's not a kid's movie. It's dark. That movie's dark. Let's give Trey, he's in the Everglades. Trey, good morning. Maybe I should say good afternoon at this point. You are filling out the number 7 spot listener's list. Go ahead.
Bedler's.
I missed you there, Trey. What was it?
Yeah, Bette Midler's Beaches.
Wow, I would totally be embarrassed to admit Beaches. You love Beaches.
That's it, man.
Wow.
That's a shot right there.
Wow.
That should be on the number right there.
You know what? Yeah, it's too bad you didn't call earlier. That feels like one that could be number. Now, do you cry when you watch Beaches? Do you cry?
I mean, that's definitely a tearjerker.
Wow.
I'm not going to lie. I'll watch it.
Wow.
I've seen it.
That's a good job out of you. That's a good job out of you, Trey.
Beaches.
So number 7 is Beaches. All right. Let's give Frank in Hollywood. Frank, go ahead. What do you got here for us? You're filling out the number 8 spot. Movies you're embarrassed to admit you love. Go ahead.
Straight up, guys. Mean Girls.
You know, I'm going to tell you something, Frank.
Mm-hmm.
I love that movie.
Mm-hmm.
Mean
oh, I
Girls.
Do.
I love that movie, and I could see you being embarrassed to admit that you love it. You know, it's partially written by Tina Fey, and she's hysterical. What's her name? Lindsay Lohan. That was when she was still, you know, somewhat normal. It's one of the first movies Rachel McAdams did. That movie, I think they made it into a Broadway show too, Frank. I think it's on Broadway, Mean Girls.
I saw it in the theaters, and I just remember, like, that was amazing. I can't tell any of my boys.
Yeah, none of us are sitting around saying, hey, you want to come over? Mean Girls is on. Let's watch Mean Girls. You're right. No one's saying that. That is a good one, though. Good job out of you, Frank. So the number 8 spot goes to Mean Girls. This is Pete. He is in Kendall. Pete, go ahead. You are filling out the number 9 spot listener's list, movies you're embarrassed about.
Okay, long-time listener. Love the show. But I'm going to admit this on your show, and I won't admit it to anybody else.
It's a safe space.
West
go on. Go on.
Side Story.
West Side Story.
Woo-hoo.
All right. You're not sitting around with your boys and watching West Side Story, right?
Benny and the Jets.
No. I'll get laughed at the house. No, couldn't do that.
All right. That's a good one. I wouldn't have thought of West Side Story. Good job out of you there, Pete. All right. We got one more spot. One more spot to fill out. Who wants it? 786-360-0790. Listener's list. Top 10 movies. You're embarrassed to admit you love. I told you for me, I got two of them. Dan Days are actually the same. I got two of them. Devil Wears Prada and To All the Boys I've Ever Loved. Now, you said you had a couple more?
I got a couple more. First of all, you know I love Victoria Justice. Victoria Justice, if you're listening, holler at your guy. Any movie she makes.
You're her guy?
Oh, well, you know, come on. I'm trying to be.
Okay.
But any movie she makes, I'm watching. And I like the movies, but I also like her, Victoria Justice. But also, some Julia Roberts, you got to add Pretty Woman in there. No hate on that.
I've never seen Pretty Woman.
Runaway Bride, got to love that. And Notting Hill. Boom, boom, boom.
I've definitely never seen Notting Hill. All right, but you're just listing off a bunch of Julia Roberts movies. I do love Julia Roberts. All right, we need the number 10 spot. Who wants it? Here's what we have so far. Pitch Perfect, Bridesmaids, Peggy Sue Got Married, Clueless, Saturday Night Fever, Little Shop of Horrors, Beaches, that's hardcore, Mean Girls, West Side Story. The number 10 spot to fill out the top 10 listeners list, movies you're embarrassed you love. The number 10 spot's going to go to Patrick. He's in Miami. He's got the honor of filling out the top 10. Patrick, movie you're embarrassed you love,
yes.
Number 10. Go ahead.
Yeah, I got a movie from the late 90s. Cruel Intentions with Ryan Phillippe.
But you're embarrassed. You're embarrassed to admit you love Cruel Intentions, yeah?
Yeah, a little bit. Can't deny.
I mean, that scene with what's her name, Sarah Michelle Gellar, and what's her name, Selma Blair. You know, where they're making out, Patrick.
Yeah,
that's a good scene.
Yes, it definitely.
All right, there you go. That's a good one there. All right, so filling out the top 10, Cruel Intentions. That movie was a big deal when it came out, you remember? All right. That's your top 10. That's the listener's list. Counting down from 10 to 1. Listener's list, top 10 movies you're embarrassed to admit you love. It's your list. 10 to 1, Cruel Intentions, West Side Story, Mean Girls, Beaches. You can make a case for Beaches, number one. Little Shop of Horrors, number five. Saturday Night Fever, Clueless, Peggy Sue Got Married, number two, Bridesmaids, and the number one movie, You're Embarrassed to Admit You Love, listeners list, Pitch Perfect. Let's hit the ID.
Say hey, Billy Mays Hayes here. Play like Mays, and I run like Hayes.
This is The Ticket. WAXY South Miami. WSFS HD2 Miramar. With Tobin and Leroy. The Zaslow Show. And Hawk and Crowder.
All right, Dan Day. We're going to talk to the former Dolphins general manager, Randy Mueller, in about 12, 13 minutes from now. So we'll do some Dolphin football with him. Thoughts heading into preseason game number three. Do a little general NFL with the former general manager. We'll get him on the phone. But right now, Dan Day is going to tell you what's going on. Go ahead.
Well, first of all, we got to get to those texts. 786-360-0790. Got some real strong ones, like Moulin Rouge.
Oh, I've never seen Moulin Rouge. I'd be embarrassed to admit that I like that.
The new Romeo and Juliet getting a lot of love.
Oh, the one with Leonardo DiCaprio mm-hmm. and Claire Danes? That movie was kind of cool, except
it was shot weird.
Yeah, I had a hard time understanding it because it was set in modern day, but they're still using the language of Shakespeare. And you remember, instead of swords, their guns were called swords, mm-hmm. right? They called the gun a sword. That was weird.
Okay, got 50 Shades of Grey. Got a lot of Sister Act 1. I like Sister Act.
Do you have to be embarrassed to admit that you like 50 Shades of Grey? I mean,
nah,
there's a lot of sex
it
in
on,
that,
man.
A lot of sex.
Ooh.
No, I don't think you need to be embarrassed to admit you like Sister Act. I remember watching that first. That movie's funny, the first
jams,
one.
Jams, man. Fools Rush In. Yeah, that's a tough one.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
Legally Blonde. I think Legally Blonde is a clever movie.
I've never seen Legally Blonde either, but I can imagine being embarrassed to admit you like
You've never
that.
Seen Pretty Woman nor Legally Blonde.
You know what? I've seen Pretty Woman, but never all the way through. Like, I've seen enough of it in parts that I could piece it together, and I've seen the whole movie.
Okay, deep swallow. Someone said Beaches. 305 says The Notebook.
Okay, listen.
Oh, please.
Let me tell you something. I like The Notebook.
Oh.
I am embarrassed to admit. You could add that. That's three for me. You could add that to my list. And my wife makes fun of me, because my wife loves it. She reads all of those Nicholas Sparks books. And my wife makes fun of me. She says Notebook's my favorite movie. It's not my favorite movie, but The Notebook is on TV. I will stop and watch it. I do like that movie. I mean, come on. They're in the rain out on the bridge. It's not in the end. It's kind of like two-thirds of the way through when they get back together. But they're out there in the rain. It wasn't over. It still isn't over. Come on. It's a great line. That's a good line.
All right, let's toughen up, guys. From the Orion Fuels and Downstairs Convenience Store Sports Desk, truly says
not a lot of testosterone on this show the last 20 minutes.
Let's talk sports. Yeah.
Football.
Football. Contact. Let's hurt each other.
Football. Hit each other in the head.
I need beer. I need sports.
I need to be concussed.
I'm not wearing deodorant today. I'm getting tough.
Smelly guy, man.
I'm all man here. Will Fuller's all man. He's back on the practice field. He says this wide receiver core is deep. He also says it's going to be tough to figure out who to keep.
Oh, man. I mean, just looking at the guys, I don't know what we're going to do. You know, we got so many receivers, so much talent. So if not here, somewhere else, I think we got 13 receivers that can play in the league. So, yeah, I think it's going to be a tough decision, so I don't know.
You can text to me at Zaslow Show like David texts, and for me it's a league of their own. I'll stop and watch it every time
it's on TV.
I don't think you need to be embarrassed to admit that you like A League of Their Own. I mean, it's a really good movie. I don't think it's embarrassing to admit you like it. Because remember, we're not talking about movies you would stop and watch every time. We're talking about just movies you're embarrassed to admit you love. I don't think you should be embarrassed to admit that you like A League of Their Own. That's not embarrassing.
Marlins, they need to man up. They've lost 8 in a row, falling to Washington 5-1 yesterday.
Yeah, but tonight you got Edward Cabrera on the hill. You're going to get your first look at him. So that's – look, it's like this every year, right? So if you're a Marlin fan – and last year was a fluke. There's no other way to look at it, okay? It was 60 games, and they were a 500 team. I think they were 31-29. They were a 500 team for 60 games. It was good enough to get you into the playoffs. Any team could be 500 for 60 games. The baseball season is so long. Last year was a fluke. There's no other way to put it. So the only thing you have to look forward to as a Marlin fan is nights like tonight, where you're going to get your first look at Edward Cabrera, see if he's going to be part of the future. Go ahead, Dante. You may continue.
K Canes QB Derek King, he's a man. He revealed his extensive knee rehab program to ESPN that included rehab twice a day, lifting weights with his teammates, and underwater exercises.
Underwater exercise? I see videos of dudes doing that. To me, that's a little bit above my pay grade, and it looks hard as hell, man. That looks like some kind of workout. Underwater? Man, a lot going on there.
Speaking of college football, the ACC, Pac-12, and Big Ten have announced a scheduling alliance, which they hope will stabilize college sports in wake of the SEC taking Texas and Oklahoma from the Big 12.
Yeah, I don't really understand what's going on there. It just kind of feels like, hey, listen, if we stick together, they can't dump us. So, okay.
See what happens there. Tonight, Los Angeles, Rudolfo Pizarro will play for the MLS All-Stars as they take on Mexico's Liga MX All-Stars.
Okay, all right.
And Inter Miami, they're back in action against Orlando up north Friday. About 8:30 is going to be when they kick off.
How about this? I'm just getting word here. You know, I spent a lot of time yesterday watching the crate challenge. You know, people were sending me videos. And they're so funny. I was showing my older son. People are getting hurt, and we're just laughing. Because I told you, Darwinism, man. Like, we're weeding these people out of our society. The crate challenge is part of that. And I'm reading here from the New York Post. TikTok. You know, a lot of these videos are made and posted on TikTok.
At Dan Day Radio.
TikTok has put out a statement responding to the viral challenge, milk crate challenge, saying that they're going to remove such videos from their platform. That's right. TikTok's not about it. TikTok prohibits content that promotes or glorifies dangerous acts, and we remove videos and redirect searches to our community guidelines to discourage such content. We encourage everyone to exercise caution in their behavior, whether online or off.
YouTube.
And apparently, hashtag milk crate challenge has racked up more than 9 million views on TikTok as of yesterday afternoon.
It's time for YouTube to step up. Did you see the Colts mascot, Blue? He successfully completed the challenge.
Well, TikTok ain't having it anymore, man.
Maybe you're not my boy, Blue.
I like these videos yesterday. I like seeing the people fall off.
What does TikTok care?
Oh, what do you mean, what do they care? They don't want to get sued. They're not about that. They're not about that lawsuit. They're trying to protect themselves, man.
From the Demesman and Dover Accident Attorney Weather Center. Oh, man, if you get hurt on that crate thing and you want to sue TikTok, maybe you can call them. It's an accident in a way.
All right.
24/7, they're available. 866-954-MORE.
It is currently. If you do a crate challenge, you get hurt. Call these guys.
Demesman and Dover. It's currently around 92 degrees in South Florida. Mostly sunny. That means it's beautiful. We've completed the crate challenge when it comes to weather. Cincinnati, not so much.
All right.
And one more thing. Let's do it. Let's take a step into the day spa.
All right, Dan Day Spy number 3, what do you got for us here?
A British couple are on the verge of breaking up after the woman decided to sell her flat to a man and his disabled son for less than what a property developer was offering her.
Okay.
This guy sounds like he's got some control issues. It's her flat. She's selling it to a man.
Now, for people who understand, a flat's like it's like an apartment.
Yeah. So she decides to sell to a man with a disabled child. It's her own choice. It's her own apartment. Another developer came in, offered her more. She said, no, I'm sticking with them. And this guy's like upset and wanting to break off the engagement.
Okay. All right.
Control issues maybe? Or,
yeah, or maybe you need to work on that then. Let's do.
Maybe he's saying, you're not very good at decision making. And maybe I was a bad decision. I don't know. We'll see what happens.
Bring in the heat, man.
Happy endings for everyone.
Let's get back to the Dolphins here. We're going to talk to the former general manager of the Dolphins, Randy Mueller. He joins the
Curiosity Stream has thousands of documentary films and shows available on demand on any device. We're the Netflix for nerds, the Hulu for history buffs, the Disney Plus for the scientist in us. There sure are a lot of streaming services, aren't there? Curiosity Stream is the one you definitely need if you're the type to nature doc and chill, if you're an armchair astronaut, if you prefer physics to psychics, or perhaps you know a precocious paleontologist. Go to curiositystream.com to learn more and sign up today.
Odyssey now has hundreds of new exclusive music stations for you to discover your new summer soundtrack.
Get moving with worthy workouts for a cardio sesh fueled by today's top artists.
Hang in with your crew? Throw it back with Picnic Party for old school jams for your cookout.
Or sail away with Odyssey's new yacht rock station, Jugger Yacht.
There are hundreds of new exclusive stations to check out today.
For summer barbecues,
road trips,
or relaxing poolside.
For every move, every interest, every passion. By Odyssey.
Celebrate the American spirit with Darius Rucker,
Zach Brown,
Chris Young, and more.
Odyssey Stars and Strings, presented by Samsung Galaxy.
You could win a flyaway and VIP tickets to this once-in-a-lifetime sold-out concert,
September 11th in New York City.
Powered by the statement-making Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 5G and Z Flip 3 5G.
Pre-order now at Samsung.com.
Enter for a chance to win the national contest of Stars and Strings
at Odyssey.com/Stars and Strings.
Whether you're renovating or building new, Riverhead Building Supply has what you need. When you choose Anderson Windows and Doors, you get high-performing, dependable products, and we support them with exceptional service. Try the 400 series, which brings you the best overall blend of performance and style. Anderson is the most trusted and recommended brand of windows and patio doors among residential contractors and builders. Head to Riverhead Building Supply, 99 The Plaza in Locust Valley, or online at rbscorp.com.
Zaslow Show, next.
Over and over. It's like missionary position every single night.
On AM 790 and FM 104.3, HD2, The Ticket.
I always think of Wonder Years when I hear this song, Joe Cocker, right? You know there's a new Wonder Years coming out. Yes, this time it revolves around a black family in the 70s. I think in the 70s. Yeah, so it's like a new version of the Wonder Years.
No shame in that. I'm excited.
Great show.
Oh, yeah, Winnie.
Everyone loved Winnie Cooper if you were around our age back then. All right. Anyway, you can text in the show, 786-360-0790. We've talked a lot of Dolphins today. Did a little on the Heat earlier. We're going to talk to former Bengals wide receiver, Fox analyst TJ Houshmandzadeh is going to join us in about an hour from now. Dolphins have the Bengals this weekend, preseason game number 3, final preseason game. So let's talk some Dolphins football here. Let's go to the Toyota of Hollywood guest line. Shop over 1,500 Toyotas indoors in one of America's largest showrooms at Toyota of Hollywood on 441 between Hollywood and Sheridan. Former Dolphins general manager is Randy Mueller, kind enough to stop by with us again here for a few minutes. Randy, good afternoon. You doing all right?
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me. I'm doing great. Hope you guys are, too.
Thanks. So from your vantage point, as a former general manager, longtime GM in the league, and you see now that there's – 3 preseason games. I mean, heck, you know, back in the day there were 6, then forever there were 4. Now we're down to 3 preseason games. So the Dolphins this weekend playing their 3rd and final preseason game. Have we seen enough, you think, out of the starting quarterback, Tua Tagovailoa? Do you sit him out the final game here? You get ready for the regular season. What do you think the approach needs to be?
Well, as you've seen, everybody around the league is kind of doing it their own way, right? I think you said we dropped from 6 to 4 to 3. We're probably on our way to even lower than that. It seems to me these dual workouts with other teams is kind of the preferred flavor now for people to get their work done. I mean, there's no question Tua is going to be the guy. So I personally would not play in the last week. I think the best way for us to struggle out the gate is to not have our quarterback. And I just don't know that the risk is worth the reward at this point. He's gone through all the OTAs. He's gone through enough of preseason. He should be set on what he needs to do. The speed of the game should not bother him come 2 weeks from now when the regular season starts. So that's just my personal opinion. I would probably rest as many guys as I could.
I really think the preseason should just be about – and you're right, you know every team is handling it. There's no playbook right now how to do 3 right. preseason games. But for me, I've always wondered, why does the college game, you know, they don't need preseason, and their regular season games do matter more, where if you lose your first regular season game in college football and you're a national championship contender, your season could be essentially ruined. The NFL is not like that, yet the NFL does the preseason games. And I understand some guys are competing for jobs, so that's important. But Randy, outside of the guys competing for jobs, why do the veterans need to play in preseason?
I couldn't agree more. I think it's a lost world, per se. It's all about the money. That the owners want to sell tickets. They want people to attend. You know, they've had it as part of their season ticket package for years. So it's all part of the business model, right? But I agree. I think the best thing about the dual workouts with other teams is they're all scripted by the coaches, but you don't have the tackling at the end of it to risk your players injury-wise. I think in college, and there are some A teams playing A teams, but for the majority of the big, you know, power conferences, they're playing the, you know, East Carolinas of the world or Montana State, and that's their preseason game, right? So they kind of work their way into it. So it's a little bit different. The other thing is in college, you have 100 guys on your team. You have 85 scholarships. So you have twice as many able and healthy bodies as the NFL. So I think the NFL really is trying to guard as much against top players getting hurt as they can. And the preseason really has become a walkthrough, a glorified chance for the guys to compete at the last 10 spots on the roster, and that's really it. I think for the most part, your work is getting done in dual practices, in OTAs, and everything leading up to it.
We got former Dolphins GM, former executive of the year as well, Randy Mueller, joining us here on the Zaslow Show. So 17 games now, regular season. Are we going to see a different strategy of sorts from some teams? Because you hear about, oh, we got more games now, we got 17 games. And I kind of stop and I'm like, they didn't add 5 games to the season. They added 1 game to the season. But is there going to be a different strategy for some teams?
Well, it'll be interesting. You're really talking about adding maybe 70 plays, right, to a physical, the physical part of it for each and every one of these players. I think what you're probably going to see, and this seems to never happen in the NFL because no lead is safe, right? But I think you're going to see teams that do get ahead later in the second half being willing to substitute more. You'd never see an offensive lineman come out of a game for the most part, even up 21. I think you're going to see they're going to try to save a few reps here and there and other guys get a chance to play just a little more. I don't know that it's going to be a vital part of every plan, but if they can cut down reps and cut down the physicality to get us through 17 weeks, I think you'll see some of that at the end of the day, just because, you know, bodies can only take so much in 17 weeks. It sounds like it's nothing, one game, but it is 70 more plays. And in some cases, depending on the position you play, that's 70 more car wrecks, you know?
Yeah. The Dolphins under Brian Flores are entering year number 3. Year number 3 of this rebuild, people can say. I think the rebuild's done, Randy. I think it's winning time now. This is a fan base that has been tortured. I mean, you were down here for a little bit. This is a fan base that has been tortured for a long time. I think we're done with this rebuild. You saw last year, this is a defense that can contend with anyone. They get the Xavien Howard situation handled. That's now behind them. Tua has looked very good so far in camp and in the 2 preseason games. You got some weapons offensively. Gesicki, they draft Waddle, number 6 overall. I think it's winning time. What should the expectation be for the Dolphin fan?
Totally agree. I think the day and age of having a 3 or 4 year rebuilding plan is over. That's behind us. The system is set up now where you can get good in a hurry. And if it takes you more than 1 year to be competitive, you know, you're probably not doing everything you can to do it. I agree. I like the expectations. If I'm Chris Greer or Brian Flores, I'm fine with the expectations being that. Hey, 10-6 last year, right? I mean, come on, let's go. It's not like we made changes, but they were changes based on what we wanted to do and things that we saw us needing to do to move forward from that. Those changes don't significantly matter at this point. It's about winning. I totally agree. And I think the expectation should be there. They're in a tough division, but they've always been in a tough division. So they need to find ways to get the offense going. And efficiency is one thing, but you're right. Adding playmakers, adding some ability to strike outside 50 yards, that's what takes you to the next level.
Now, most of it's going to revolve around how much Tua improves from year number 1 to year 2. Full disclosure, Randy, we got Randy Mueller, former Dolphins general manager, here with us. Full disclosure, I'm a Tua guy. I liked him coming out of college. I liked what I saw last year. Didn't like everything. He tailed off, obviously, late in the season, but he was 6-3 as a rookie, and he's looked real good in training camp and especially this past weekend in the preseason game against Atlanta. What kind of jump is realistic for a young quarterback from year number one to year number two in a general manager's eyes?
Well, I think you should expect a big jump this year because obviously last year without the OTAs, without any preseason, that's hard, especially for a young guy. But I think the style in which Tua plays, you know, it's a timing, it's a rhythm type passer. I think some things need to be right around him, and they've made some additions to their offensive line. Shoot, they've spent a lot of high picks on offensive linemen. So if the offensive line isn't better, that's not Tua's fault. That's somebody else's fault. So you invest that kind of draft capital, you better be pretty good. So, you know, I think in the end, he should improve immensely. I think the one thing that always bothers me a little bit with Tua is just that he's not a big guy, and the pocket kind of gets noisy in there. So the durability factor is always going to be there for me, but he should be better at his trade without a doubt. He's not memorizing a system now. He's progressing as a player and developing his craft. So that's a total different mindset than where he was last year.
Let's talk a little bit about this division. You know, everybody is picking Buffalo. I haven't seen a single person in the world not pick Buffalo to win the AFC East. Josh Allen really struggled first 2 years in the league, and then he was phenomenal last year. Did you see enough? Was that one incredible year from Josh Allen enough for a general manager to say, you know what, this is Buffalo. They're going to be really good for a really long time.
Yeah, I'm put me in that column. I agree with it. I think that the inefficiencies that were brought out about Josh Allen early on and being inaccurate, I didn't think there was a lot of merit to that. This kid was throwing to neighbor kids at Wyoming, right? Plus, he's learning the new system. I don't think you can judge all of that till the guy gets comfortable. Same as we just talked about with Tua. He needs to be comfortable in his surroundings to improve his trade. I think the Bills are good. I think they've done a really good job of building around him. They have offense. They have defense. And now they have confidence, right? They've got, as long as they can stand prosperity, and that's a thing. That's a real thing. They've got to have the same grind, the same mentality that got them there last year. Again, this year, I think they should be fine, but I wouldn't sleep on New England. I think New England has maybe the most improved label because of the changes that they've made, and I'm still not ready to bet against Bill Belichick at the end of the day, that's for sure.
Well, what do you make of the Cam Newton situation there? It feels a little bit fishy to me. It's very, un-New England Patriot-like, if you will, that there's this miscommunication with such an important player, such an important position like the quarterback in Cam Newton, that there was confusion when to take the test, where you're supposed to take the test. I don't know. It feels kind of weird to me. What do you make of that?
Yeah, it's definitely not New England-like, that's for sure. They usually are pretty buttoned down with everything they do and very structured. I think the difference is we've seen Cam at an improved level these first couple weeks of preseason, and now you've got the fallback in Mac Jones, who has proved he can kind of run the offense and be functional. So I think it may be a little weird. It may give you a weird feeling, but this is a way better team personnel-wise than they were last year. They made uncharacteristic mistakes, and they just didn't have the horses to compete last year. They coached them up as good as they could, but this is a total different team. I mean, we all know the money they spent in free agency, the changes they've made. They've got a really good team, and I think one that's going to be hard to not pick as a playoff team at the end of the day.
What's your general opinion as a GM? We got Randy Mueller, former Dolphins GM here. You can go to MuellerFootball.com. You can check out everything Randy's got going on. What is your general opinion as a former GM when it comes to the rookie quarterback? You know, you see Zach Wilson in New York, and I don't even know who their backup is, okay? They're starting him, right? He's the guy. But then you look in San Francisco, you got Garoppolo there with Trey Lance. Jacksonville, you got Minshew with Trevor Lawrence. In general, Justin Fields and Andy Dalton in Chicago, do you like the idea of going the veteran at first, letting the rookie sit and watch a little bit, or, you know, if he looks ready, you throw him right out there?
I think it just depends. I think you've got to put your eyes on it, and it's got to pass your eye test. You can't let the fans dictate who they want. I understand the angst in Chicago to see Justin Fields. Hey, I've seen him play too. He's a good player. I just think each situation is different. It's done where you can say we're going to sit a guy for 2 years. That's just not going to happen. These guys are coming to the league way better trained. They're further on the learning curve of developing their craft. And I think you've got to end up playing them sooner than later. So I don't know. I think each case has to be analyzed individually. And I can understand it's a tough thing for staffs, for coaches, for players. And I'm just glad that we have some preseason where these guys can progress a little bit in that they can not, like we talked about with Tua, just memorize, and they can actually understand concepts and things that get them to level two and level three of the position. What I'm not in favor of is throwing kids out there and having them at level one of learning their trade and just getting killed. I think that could destroy them. So I would always want to have a veteran. I would always want to have a backdrop. I think if you even had to start a rookie early on and end up benching him for a couple of weeks, I don't think you're going to ruin him. You just got to keep him upright and keep the people around him healthy. And I think his vision for the future is easy to see with a veteran operating in front of him. I should say it's easier to see.
What do you make of Brian Flores, the head coach, through 2 years?
I like him a lot. He was my coach of the year last year, about three quarters of the way through. I thought he did a great job. I think sometimes change can be good. They've made a lot of changes, and I'm not sure that sometimes we don't have to minimize change and just go with what we have. They've elected to keep, rotating players in and out. They spent a lot of money last year. Now some of those guys aren't even here. So I think he's good. I would play for him any day of the week, and I think players like him. And it comes down to, with head coaches in my mind, they've got to make decisions that gain the confidence of their players in how to win games. He changed the culture in his mind, but it's really about what can you do on Sundays to help your team, and I think Brian's done a good job of that.
Is this Dolphin team a playoff team, Randy?
Oh, I think so. I think it's all about health, and nobody wants to hear that, but it's all about health, and that comes down to really having depth, and there's not a lot of depth around the league anymore. So if the Dolphins view their backups as having a chance, if they've got some strength in numbers, I do think they'll be a competitive playoff team. We got to keep Tua upright and make him comfortable so that he can be a rhythm passer, and time will tell how that works out.
Great job, Randy. Always like having you on the show. Really good stuff. We appreciate it.
Thanks, guys. Anytime.
That's Randy Mueller. Again, MuellerFootball.com. You can check out what the former NFL Executive of the Year, former Dolphin GM, has got going on there, and he's always very good. So there you have it. All right. If you miss any of the show today, use the Rewind feature on the Odyssey app. You can go check that out. We're going to talk to former Bengals wide receiver, Dolphins and Bengals this weekend. We're going to talk to TJ Houshmandzadeh next hour. But coming up, we're going to do a big deal or not a big deal on the Zazzle Show next.
Curiosity Stream has thousands of documentary films and shows available on demand on any device. We're the Netflix for nerds, the Hulu for history buffs, the Disney Plus for the scientist in us. There sure are a lot of streaming services, aren't there? Curiosity Stream is the one you definitely need if you're the type to nature doc and chill, if you're an armchair astronaut, if you prefer physics to psychics, or perhaps you know a precocious paleontologist. Go to curiositystream.com to learn more and sign up today.
Sports bettors, are you ready? Are you ready for a faster way to win? When you bet with PointsBet, you get faster bets, faster withdrawals, and faster rewards. Experience this premium sportsbook for yourself and sign up with code BETSWEATS, BETSWEATS, to get $100 in free bets when you deposit 20. Must be present in New Jersey, Indiana, Iowa, or Illinois. Must be 21 or older. Additional T's and C's apply. If you or somebody you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-GAMBLER if in New Jersey and Illinois, 1-800-9-WITH-IT if in Indiana, 1-800-BETS-OFF if in Iowa.
Celebrate the American spirit with Darius Rucker, Zach Brown, Chris Young, and more. Odyssey Stars and Strings, presented by Samsung Galaxy. You could win a flyaway and VIP tickets to this once-in-a-lifetime sold-out concert, September 11th in New York City. Powered by the statement-making Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 5G and Z Flip 3 5G. Pre-order now at Samsung.com. Enter for a chance to win the national contest of Stars and Strings at Odyssey.com/Stars and Strings.
Summer only savings await at your local Hyundai dealer. Where you go from there is up to you. Huge savings, new vehicles arriving daily, and of course, America's best warranty. Get in to get away with it all at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Secure your 2021 Sonata or Elantra today for 0% APR for 60 months, plus zero payments for 90 days. See your Hyundai dealer now during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end September 6, 2021. Call 562-314-4603 for offer terms and details.
Let's get back to two-time championship broadcaster Jonathan Zaslow.
Tyler Hero coming up with the money shot there
on the Zaslow Show. And now, a Zaslow exclusive. Big deal or not a big deal?
All right, let's do some big deal or not a big deal. Randy Mueller was good. You want to go back and listen to a little Dolphins with the former GM there. Use the rewind feature on the Odyssey app. Got a lot going on today. We've done a lot of Dolphins football. That's good. Everybody wants to hear that. And we talked a lot about movies. Okay, our listeners list, by the way, today. If you missed that, use the rewind feature on the Odyssey app. Listeners list today, top 10 movies you're embarrassed you like. And you can go back and you can check that out. And also, the start of the show today, we were reacting to a very controversial question that ESPN SportsCenter Twitter account put out last night. They gave us 9 sports movies. Only 3 of them can stay. You got that? That means only 3 last, and the others are gone. Like, they never happen. All right? And we'll give you that list again coming up in a few minutes. So let's do big deal, not a big deal. What do you got?
All righty, here we go. The Bucks and head coach Mike Budenholzer have signed a 3-year extension that's going to keep him with the team through the 2024-2025 season. Is that a big deal or not a big deal?
It's a big deal. I think Budenholzer is a good coach. You know, he was a real punching bag for the rest of the league. And I don't think it was deserved. I mean, look, the head coach is going to catch a lot of heat when he has a history of regular season teams, Atlanta and Milwaukee, who are top seeds, literally the number one seeds in their conference in the regular season, and then they lose in the postseason. And here's the fact of the matter, okay? Those Atlanta teams that he had that were number one, they kept losing to LeBron, you know? And those number one teams that he had in Milwaukee, they lost to Toronto, who then ended up winning the championship, and they lost to the Heat, who ended up going to the finals and beating down everyone in the Eastern Conference, okay, that year. So, I didn't think it was deserved. He ended up making changes in the finals. You'll remember, you had, what's his name, Bobby Portis playing a ton. You know, he made some adjustments. He made some moves there. I think Mike Budenholzer is a good coach. And I know a lot of people can say, hey, you know, if Kevin Durant was a shoe size smaller, well, guess what, he ain't. Okay, he's not a shoe size smaller. He shouldn't have had his foot on the line. And so they go to overtime, and the Bucks still win game 7. Them's the breaks, man. If he was a shoe size smaller, Budenholzer would have been fired. Eh, it's stupid arguments, all right? It's not how it went down. So I think it's deserved. I think Budenholzer's a good coach.
I do like the idea that a guy that came a game away from losing his job and maybe even being told, if you don't win it all, you're done, goes and wins it all, gets the extension.
His teams are always good, man. They're, as a head coach, his teams are always good. And you get to the postseason, and you got to catch some breaks. And you know what? Up until this year, they hadn't caught breaks. And this year, they caught some big breaks. That's how it goes.
British national Harry Kane. He has said that he is staying with Tottenham in the Premier League. He has rebuffed Man City. Now, everyone's turned to Ronaldo. That is Man City's target. Cristiano Ronaldo possibly going to Man City. Big deal, not a big deal.
Well, that sounds like a big deal, but I you know, I really don't have a good grasp on how, you know, the transfers and all that stuff work in those leagues overseas. But it feels to me, it sounds to me, like these players are constantly changing teams. Is that true? Do I have the right impression there?
Some of them do, yeah. They bounce around.
It feels like they're constantly changing teams. Anyway.
No salary caps. It's all about the money.
Yeah, I think salary cap's evil, man. I don't like salary cap. I think that, you know, you're talking, like the NBA thinks that they get parity, although it's the league with the least parity, but the, which, hint, hint, but the NBA believes that having the salary cap makes things all fair for all the teams. No, it doesn't. If everything's equal, the destination cities are going to be the ones who sign the best players. It's when you don't have everything equal that the smaller market teams can compete. That's why the NFL, okay, and granted, there's a salary cap in the NFL, but there's no cap, there's no max salary for an individual player. So if you have Team X that is willing to pay player Y more money than the other teams, even though it's a small market team, they're going to be able to get that player. The NBA, you got the salary cap and a max salary per player. So if everything's even, hey, the big dogs are going to continue to be the big dogs.
We both agree, as long as it doesn't feature any of our teams here in Miami, relegation would be awesome in the United States.
Oh, man, relegation would be crazy. I mean, you know how exciting those games would be at the end of the season? Like the Miami Marlins right now.
Ooh.
These games would be so important that if the Marlins, if they stay in last place, they're going to be a Triple-A team next year?
No.
I'd be so into these games over the last month. It'd be very exciting. But it'd also be terrible. Can you imagine the Marlins are going to be in AAA next year?
You don't want to see the Marlins in the AAA. You do not want to see the Dolphins in the XFL, and you do not want to see the Heat.
Can
in the
you
G
imagine
League.
If the Dolphins, like Brian Flores' first year here, oh, they're tanking? There'd be no teams would ever be tanking because you think the Dolphins think Stephen Ross wants his team to be relegated to the XFL? That'd be crazy.
The Heat in the G League? No, we're not going
crazy.
To Sioux Falls. We're not playing Sioux Falls.
Like, you imagine the Heat all of a sudden they're in the Big Three, Ice Cube's league.
Yeah,
Miami Heat now, Big Three.
Oh man, it'd be interesting.
It'd be crazy.
20 years ago today, a somber day, because Aaliyah died in a plane crash.
Wow.
On the way to the Bahamas, is that a big deal or not a big deal?
Oh yeah, you're gonna get me to say it's not a big deal that Aaliyah died. No, it's a big deal, of course. Aaliyah was very popular, a very tragic death. Yes, no other way to put it.
Great music, great actress, good person, good looking. Aaliyah, might throw on some Aaliyah tonight. Get this, a Gulfport, Florida house is on sale for $900,000. Here's one of the quirks of the house. It was built around an 100-year-old oak tree. So the oak tree grows throughout the house. Big deal, not a big deal.
Oh, I've seen that before. That's a big deal, but and I would hate it. I've seen that before. I don't like it. I don't want nature in my house. Nature's for outside. Nature's not for inside.
You do bring up a good point there. Nature is for outside.
Nature's for outside. Nobody ever says, hey, let's go enjoy some nature inside the house. Nobody says that.
Yeah, that's why you dust and that's why you sweep and vacuum. Yeah. You want nature out of your house.
Yeah, nature is outside. It's not in my house.
You don't want bugs in your house, do you?
Nope.
Don't want nature in your house. Okay.
Nope.
Come to a consensus. There we go. A man has skated across Canada some 6,271 miles to raise awareness to save the bees. Big deal or not a big deal?
Not a big deal. I mean, I know Morgan Freeman's out there telling me I got to save the bees, but I don't see it.
When did that become the trendy thing to get behind, save the bees?
Not trendy to me. I don't see it. You know, I could live without honey.
Oh.
That's for sure.
I don't know.
I like honey, but I could live without it. It's not that big a deal. I could definitely live without being out at the pool in my backyard, the Zaslow Mansion patio, and my kids getting freaked out because there's a bee around the pool. I could live without that. I don't think we need bees. I don't. And don't at me either with all the reasons we need bees. We don't. We'd survive.
Oh, man, but a good peanut butter and honey sandwich every once in a while?
No, I don't do that.
Honey on top of your oatmeal?
No, it's not necessary. We'd be able to live without honey. It's not that big a deal.
Okay.
Stop trying to make me like honey.
A British woman, she snagged a rugby player after stalking him for several weeks, then deciding her best action would be to throw him a paper plane asking him out. Big deal or not a big deal?
Yeah, it's a big deal. I like that. I think that's fun. You know, I miss the days where, you know, when you were in middle school or even high school, kids these days, they don't get to experience the passing the notes. That was always exciting, you know,
yeah.
In the hall. Ooh, I sent her a note earlier. We're going to see each other in the hall. Is she going to pass it back to me? That was always very exciting. But now they don't do that anymore because it's texting. Okay?
Oh, that's no...
Yeah, they don't do notes anymore. That was always so exciting where, oh, I can't wait to give her this note. I hope she's going to give the note back to me here. What's it going to say? That's very exciting. Kids don't do that anymore.
I will say every once in a while I'll get a text before the show or during the show. And it's exciting, though, but it's not like the old notes, man.
Yeah, but for kids, you're missing out on that. You know, that note was exciting. Will you go out with me? Circle yes, circle no.
You're on pins and needles until you had to see him again.
Yeah, it was fun.
Oh, man. Or I have a friend that likes you. Do you have someone that you like?
Absolutely.
Write in who you like, and I'll see if I can connect you, and hopefully it's you.
Absolutely.
Oh, man. Ladies, bring it back. Guys would love... I mean, if a girl threw me... a paper plane, and on it said, "Do you want to go out sometime?"
I like it.
I'm going out with her.
Yeah.
I don't care who she looks or what she looks like or what she's doing, just for her creativity.
Tell you, I wouldn't mind my wife passing me a note every now and then.
Actually, you know what? This weekend, I think I'm going to make a paper plane and ask somebody out, and I'm going to see how it goes.
You know, how about I'm sitting on the couch watching TV, and you know, my wife walks by me to get to the kitchen. How about you throw me a note? Let's see what we got going on here.
I think that's sexy.
I think it'd be exciting.
I'm going up. Okay, no, get it going. That's what I'm talking about. Go on. Go on. We're going on right now. A man has sparked debate online after posting that when he leaves a hotel room, he stacks the pillows and rolls up all the covers in order for what he thinks makes the job easier for the maids. Is that a big deal or not a big deal?
It's not a big deal. You know, it's nice what he's doing, but, you know, makes the job easier.
I don't know.
It's their job. You don't need to make their job easier. It's just their job. It is what it is. You know, I would say, if anything, you leave her a tip. If that's what you want to do, if you're trying to make things easier, I think they'd much rather your tip than you making the job easier. I don't think this is a big deal.
Are you like me? Do you pretty much trash the hotel room?
No. What do you mean do I pretty much trash the hotel room?
Like,
no.
right when you walk in, dive into the bed, roll around, run around, throw some papers around, leave empty beer cans all over the place?
No, I'm not trashing anything, man. No, I'm like a normal person. I'm 40 years old. I'm not trashing hotel rooms. What's the point in that?
Oh, I thought we were kind of coming to consensus on a lot of things.
No,
today.
That's not a consensus that we trash the hotel room.
I took it too far, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to L.A. for Labor Day weekend.
Grow up a little.
Watch out, Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Come to trash my hotel room, run around naked, leave towels all over the place, bucket overturned.
Oh, man.
Love it. Finally, a pilot had to make an emergency landing of a passenger plane in Sudan after being attacked by a stowaway cat. Big deal or not a big deal?
Oh, this is not a big deal. I mean, you're telling me you're attacked by a cat and you have to do an emergency landing? It's a cat. It's not that big a deal. I mean, I know they usually they tell you not, you don't want to declaw the cats. You know, you're not supposed to do that. So they could scratch you. Matter of fact, I got an old scar on my knee from a cat that I had as a kid, you know? So I know they'll scratch your ass. But I feel like you can get things under control, that you can keep flying the plane.
Say, man up, just fly the plane, man.
Yeah.
First of all, there shouldn't be a stowaway cat on a plane.
Right.
But
if you need to, you grab the cat by the scruff of the neck, all right? You give it a toss. Get the hell out of here.
For the better cause and better safety of everyone else, right?
Right.
Man up.
Can you imagine? The cat says, listen, we got to do emergency landing in the Sudan. Someone's cat got loose.
Yeah. Scruffles got me.
Here.
Scratched me.
Get out of here.
I mean, cat scratches are no fun, but it's not the end of the world.
Not the end of the world.
Not the end of the world.
Unless the cat scratched out his eyeballs.
Well, then,
in that case,
you might have
you need to land in the Sudan.
You're going to have some problems making that landing, though. But, yeah, so there you go. It's big deal. Not a big deal.
Hour number 4 on the Zaslow Show is next.
The COVID-19 pandemic showed us how a microscopic virus could upend our lives. There is so much out there that we need to understand. But for every threat, there are heroes working at the edges of science and policy to protect us. I'm Dr. Abdul El-Sayed, former Detroit Health Director and host of Crooked Media's America Dissected. Every episode, I talk to the doctors, scientists, culture makers, and policy leaders who are working out new ways to protect us against our biggest threats. New episodes of America Dissected every Tuesday. Listen on Odyssey, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
On Pod Save the World, we want to be your cheat sheet for global events. My name is Tommy Vitor, and each week, my co-host Ben Rhodes and I break down the biggest stories from around the world. Ben and I both worked on President Obama's national security staff, and we'll introduce you to the activists, politicians, and journalists who can help us understand what's going on around the world, what it means for the United States, and what it's like being inside the White House Situation Room during a crisis. Listen on Odyssey, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your pods.
CuriosityStream has thousands of documentary films and shows available on demand on any device. We're the Netflix for nerds, the Hulu for history buffs, the Disney Plus for the scientist in us. There sure are a lot of streaming services, aren't there? CuriosityStream is the one you definitely need if you're the type to nature doc and chill, if you're an armchair astronaut, if you prefer physics to psychics, or perhaps you know a precocious paleontologist. Go to CuriosityStream.com to learn more and sign up today.